Hello, I'm His Ordinator and I'm a lecturer in Metallurgy, preaching Sikh Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. Christ is known Satguru in Punjabi. So the first Satguru that came in the world was Satguru Jesus. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Now, you don't need to believe me. You have to find it yourself. So, its gospel is by the grace of our Supernatural Father, and nobody can give you. And that Supernatural Father lives in His temple. This is the temple of God. He's inside here. If you are not greedy, if you work for money and cheating people, then Satan is in and God is out. Like the TRAITOR priest, they are working for Mammon. Remember, Peter killed Ananias and Sapphira for the love of Mammon, and they told pack of lies to Peter. So this is the nature of the people who are working for Mammon, like Tony Blair and Bush, saying that Saddam Hussein had a weapon of mass destruction, but none were found. They are blasphemers, and this super Hitler Putin is going to sort them up. You will see it soon. Blasphemy is not forgivable. So here unrending exposition of St. Matthew 26, verse 14 to 25. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. That was first delivered by the Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim Allah Parbrahm, that dwells within His temple, living temple, not dead one of brick and mortar. His temple of God, John 4, you know, you worship God in truth and in spirit, created by the demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah. Same thing, etc. And it is called Harmandir, or Emmanuel, God is with us, according to Saint Matthew 26:14-25. Now, Marcion had this concept of real Father and the Demiurge. But these people who are in the churches today, they are the byproduct of the Messianic Jews who corrupted the thing and made the thing worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45 is fulfilled in the Messianic Jews. So you have to be alert. So one of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, that was thrown out of the Wedding Banquet of the Son, Christ Jesus, into the darkness that the temple priest had created. Darkness is a temple priest, and that's why Jesus threw Judas Iscariot out into the darkness to have the company of the temple priest. Priest had created, went to the evil spirited chief priest of darkness, of his own kind, and said, "What are you willing to give me if I hand him over to you?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver, as all the apostles were very efficient in preaching the gospel truth, that a stranger will not know who is the real Christ Jesus, but the insider of the evil spirited Judas Iscariot, who was twice born, but evil spirit, knew, as the evil spirited temple priest knew, towards whom Jesus is directing the last parable of wine press, the Jerusalem temple that made the moral laws. As today, the Church of England is changing the New Testament, that God is not our father, but parent. So they want to change it, New Testament, and call it parent, you know. They change it at will, you know. And parent giving equal representation to both male and female in flesh. So the men of flesh only know the things of flesh. They cannot know things of spirit. Church of England is Church of Satan. Nearest to the God is Salvation Army people, which they hate. So male and female in flesh, but the gospel is for our supernatural soul and not the physical body. Supernatural soul has no male and female. That's why Jesus said, neither male nor female, not Jew nor Gentile. We are all sons of the Most High. Soul and not the physical body to whom the moral law applies. In other words, the Church of England priests are super blind, in which they glorify. Oh dear. In which they glorify the two World War soldiers who died and others, in such as the viceroys of India and South Africa, who killed and looted the people, as to have glorified God. That God is not the one which is loving and merciful, which is a dear God. Church of England God is Mammon, money. That's why there's so much cheating going on in this country. Whereas I lived in Ghana for 14 years, such cheating are not known over there. Whereas the much despised Salvation Army people, the Church of England people despise those Salvation Army people, proclaimed that their soldiers in the two world war died for the king and country, the gospel truth. They spoke the gospel truth, though they hate them, as the Jewish people hated the Samaritans. The Salvation Army people represent Samaritans. They look after the people in agape, whereas the Church of England is a vicious church. Only the Church of England bishop can go and sit in the house of Lord, nobody else. So you can see how racist they are in this time. And from that time on, he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, the twice-born brethren and not the once-born disciples of the crook Messianic Jews. Messianic Jews, they have made the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. I will make a video on that one. The temple priest, Messianic Jews, the temple priest, you remember wine press, he said these temple priests, husbandmen, are no good for any other job than priestly job. And they are the one who took over the enemy of God with the written Torah, Jewish leaven, under their armpit, and they corrupted the church. And they colluded with the Romans, after collusion with the Romans, as they were before the arrival of Jesus, they were colluding with them. So they start killing the apostles by throwing them before animals to be eaten alive. They made a good show of their death, you know. And apostle died. Then Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, he took the sword to soft them up, because people of Ishmael, they have the morality. And the Isaac people, they are immoral, unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, saltless people. So this man of salt, Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, he took a sword and sorted them up. Otherwise, they would have created the mess in the whole world. So therefore, the Jewish people, Messianic Jews, they fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So many things you will see. The temple priests who were fit for no other job than the priestly corrupted the New Testament, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Christ Jesus, approached Jesus and said, "Where do you want us to prepare for you to eat the Passover?" So his brethren, you know, approached him and asked him, "Where do you want to sit?" He said, "Go into the city to a certain man who had just built a new spatial, quite big house, representing the Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, of the new covenant of the Holy Spirit in which we have fellowship, which is common sense. Holy Spirit is common sense. Here also remember that the tomb in which the body of Jesus was laid was also virgin, befitting the Second Adam Yahshua. Jesus was given the name Yahshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the first Adam. Jesus was second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph was foster father. So that's why the house that was into which the Jesus celebrated the Passover was virgin. Nobody had lived there, as nobody had died in the where the Jesus body was laid. So first primordial Adam, born out of Yahweh and Virgin Mary. So where Virgin Mary was sired by Yahweh, and tell him, the teacher, because God himself in the name of his anointed Son Christ, of the name Yeshua, says. Now, Christ is the title. Christ, it stands for His Word, and His Word is God. So when God is inside you, and you speak logically, then you are representing God. And so you have seen the face of God. It is not seen by these two eyes, but the third eye of logical reasoning. So you must be capable of logical reasoning and then speaking out your mind, impartial, like a little child. Not that you take a side, biased. If you are biased, then you are lost. Then you have become entered into the kingdom of Satan to please the people as the psychic people do. Keep your face facing God and not the public. Turn your side to public, back to the public, face to the God, as Moses did. Moses saw the face of God, he showed the back to the people, and that is what we should do. Yahweh, and tell him, the teacher, because God himself, in the name of his anointed Son Christ, Christ is the Son of Elohim, whereas Yeshua is the Son of Yahweh. That is where John the Baptist baptized Jesus in the name of Yahweh, whereas the Jewish man, he baptized in the name of Abraham. My appointed time draws near. In your house, I shall celebrate the Passover with my laboring brethren, and not the disciple, once-born disciple of the rabbi, the moral teachers. The root of the word disciple is discipline, and the moral laws teachers, rabbis and Pharisees, Sadducees, they discipline their intake of the natural voice by teaching the moral of Moses for morality. Then on that base you build the spirituality, as Peter obeyed the rabbis. See, he had the morality, speaking the truth. Over the truth is built the super truth, the gospel truth, which you receive from God. If you are not truthful, you cannot get the gospel truth. The twice born brethren and not the once born disciples, a corruption by the Messianic Jews to create similar situation as in the temple before the arrival of Jesus, who killed the apostles. The Messianic Jews, they killed the apostles by throwing them before the animals to be eaten alive. Then did as Jesus had suggested to the freed men and not ordered to the slave disciples. In Jesus, we don't commandment or either or anything. He is not Lord or anything. Lord has slaves. He is our brother. We have one Father. We are all brethren. And prepare the Passover in that virgin house, because new covenant is to be established. And there Jesus baptized the 11 in Holy Spirit. When it was evening, he reclined at table with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, "Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me." Deeply distressed at this, there is, you know, corruption by the Messianic view to show, you know, how the people were disturbed and all that, but they were not, they were all happy. Deeply distressed at this, they began to say to him, one after another, "Surely it is not I, my brother, and not Lord, Lord that have slaved, you know." Sorry. "Lord that have slaves, introduced by the evil spirited Messianic Jews." They introduce all these lordship and all that, you know. In Jesus we have one Father, we are all brethren. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. He said in reply, "He who has dipped his hand into the dish with me, Judas Iscariot," they pretend that they are men of God, they love God very much, as the doctor of priests in justice do. "The greatest hypocrite who put on fanciful robes and love to be addressed as fathers." You go to this Catholic church, over there they put on whitewashed robe, very beautiful. And if I have a church nearby me, Catholic one, I address the priest brother. He said, no, "I'm not brother, I'm father." I said, I know my father, where from I got my surname. I know my supernatural father, two fathers I know. What type of father you are then?" He had no answer, you know. So that is the way they are, you know. They are still thinking to be addressed as fathers, as the rabbi used to be addressed. Robes and love to be addressed as fathers in the churches today show to the people that they are men of God, but love Mammon and position in the churches. Hello? 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 No, I'm busy now. Can you call later on? I'm busy. So, sorry, you know. Fathers in the churches today show to the people that they are men of God, but love Mammon. They steal money from the purse and all that. You see how they have robbed the churches. And they are morally immoral. They are raped the women and all that, you know, sexual. And position in the churches, they want the high position in the church is one who will betray me. And they like the Metropolitan Bishops, if you see the Russian bishop, you know, and their priests, how they are beautifully dressed in golden robes and all that, with big head. They put on a big head gear to frighten the simple-minded, childlike devotees in the churches. Betray today. They betray them, you know. They're cheating money. They ask any church that asks for donation is a church of Satan, because the first people who joined the Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, they sold all their possessions. They have nothing to do with Mammon. So anybody who asks for Mammon, donation and anything, is a church of Satan. As simple as that. The Son of Man indeed goes as it is written of him. Our, you know, not a single hair will come off without the will of our supernatural Father. So everything is written there. So you should preach gospel from the rooftop and not hide. And here is a man who is running a ministry, which is an international military ministry, and he won't speak the gospel truth. This major general, he went to Iraq after the destruction and killing of Saddam Hussein. And he gave a sermon in Reading to men's breakfast. And I got this card from him. He told the people that Saddam Hussein has no weapons of mass destruction. Everybody knows now. But they proclaimed, Tony Blair and Bush, that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction, so we want to kill him. What a lame excuse. Anybody who is sensible, he should shout from the rooftop that it was a blasphemy against Holy Spirit. So I wrote to him that there were no weapons, though they were blasphemers. Go to the rooftop and proclaim it. No way. British, and he is not destined to preach gospel. He loves Mammon. All they are asking for is Mammon, Mammon, Mammon. And no word of God comes from them, because they are greediest people in the world. So don't believe them. Speak to them. I go to the church, at Catholic churches, you know, sometime, and I over there in Oxford University, Pusey House. I gave my leaflet to one of my devotees over there, and that gave to the priest. This man has given me this one. He came to me, Mr. Nature, you can't give leaflet to the our people. And here's the leaflet that I gave. It was small like this, you know, not big. So I gave it to him, and then he told me, you can't give it. You are not allowed to give the leaflet. I told them that St. Paul said, listen to everyone and wet them in Holy Spirit. So you don't want to listen to me. And then I asked him, in Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. So where do you stand in the ministry of Christ Jesus? No middleman, because anybody who stands between man and God, he is Antichrist, and you are one of them. So when I called him Antichrist, he wasn't happy, but he could not argue with me. And that's how they are to be stopped. And they are stupid people, you know. I call them super dumb peace carrying holy books. So don't be afraid of their uniform or of their big, big hat, as the Russian people are. They should confront them and tell them when Christ Jesus, it was Jesus who died on the cross, and Jesus rose on the third day, not Christ. Christ is the spiritual self, not to be seen by these two naked eyes, perceived by the third eye of logical reasoning. So you ask these priests, you know, who say Christ has risen, ask them when Christ died. Christ and for His word. His word is God. So when your God died, that He rose again, no sense at all. So what you should speak should be sensible, that only the people possessing common sense, they can only speak. That's why common sense is Holy Spirit. So let's carry on. I have put a lot of videos on such a topic. So, where we are? So, the big head gear, these Russian bishops, to frighten the simple-minded, childlike devotee in the churches, betray today. They betray them, you know. That's why Jesus says, the one who betrays a childlike person, a millstone should be put around his neck and he should be drowned into the sea. But they are there, dominating them. So they are churches of Satan. The Son of Man indeed goes, as it is written of Him by our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. But woe to that evil-spirited, hypocrite man, as the Catholic bishops killed many Cathars in France, you know. They burned 250 in one church, by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. So a millstone should be put around and drawn in the sea. It would be better for that man if we had never been born. It is very important. He rebuked him, you know. A rebuke that was enough for Judas Iscariot to kill himself after the death of Jesus. That's why he killed himself. Because he was the prince of darkness, not the king and emperor as they were in India. So prince means he made the mistake as the children do. In India, we had the people of Khatri tribe who were kings and emperors of darkness. They became Mohammedan, and in the mosque, mullahs, this Ayatollah Khomeini come from India, Kashmir. You can see what havoc he has created in Iran. So darkness, sword power was used to kill their stooges in Mammon. So they were the created an army of Satan, you know, Mammon, and they fought against the Sikhism and the royal king in India we had. So much more in my other videos. Then the hypocrite Judas, his betrayer, said in reply, "Surely it is not I, Rabbi, the way these hireling doctor priests and the stooges would say, when you tell them that in Christ Jesus everyone is to give his own account to God and they are anti-Christ. If you tell them they are anti-Christ, then see how they react, you know. But to a childlike devotees, they will pretend to be the men calling themselves church fathers. They are church fathers, you know, representing our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. And their stooges are so stupid that they believe them to be the fathers. And they call them father, you know. They are stupid people. And that's why they call our Father in heaven in the prayer. That is reflect that they are all blind people. Our Father is not in heaven alienated with that was Yahweh. Our Father Elohim is inside here, living God in living temple, not in the dead temple, brick and built of Yahweh. As the outer court was of the in Jerusalem, there were two, where the Judas carried through the 30 shekel, that was the court of Yahweh. And that's why the Yahweh is the potter. That's why they buy a field and call it Potter's Field. I attended a lecture in Oxford Catholic Pusey House in which the two robed priests, they were, you know, one Metropolitan, Clastos, I think his name, and the other was the one priest over there. They were calling themselves each other father. I asked them, who is son among you two? He answered, so he told me, you know, they were the one that's somebody, you know, calls the people son, and he became father, so we are father like him. That's the Clastos told me. So let's see. He answered, you have said so. That means you have said so. These uniformed robed priests know it very well that they are not the men of God, but for greed and position, they will knowingly carry on cheating the devotees of Christ Jesus. They do it knowingly, you know, not blindly. If you tell them the gospel truth, they turn their faces away from you. They don't want to turn their deaf ear to you. Remember that Marcion did preach the gospel. He had the concept of the demiurge and the real. But the hypocrite hireling dog-collar priest created by the Messianic Jews, created by the Messianic Jews, Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, called him a heretic. And so am I a big heretic. In Reading, there was a priest in Kerry Baptist Church. First of all, the Baptist was a witness to the light, but not the light. All these Baptist churches, the church belonged to saint in the name of Christ Jesus, and not to Baptist. So you can see they are worshipping in a church which does not belong to God, but to the witness to the God, John the Baptist, an angel, or a same thing as a prophet Elijah. So they don't know where God is. So I told him, you know, the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman, explained to him. And on the next Sunday, I went to attend his church, and the passage came, you cannot love Mammon and God at the same time. You will love one and hate the other. So I was thinking he's being paid money by the church. He's a hireling. Let's see what he will say. I was just smiling. And he opened his mouth. Among you is sitting a person, he pointing to me, who gives his own literature as I give it in the Oxford University. And the priest said, you can't give it. So don't take it anything from him unless it has a stamp of the church. And this man is a heretic. So he proclaimed in the whole church that I'm a heretic. And then I went to an Oriel College. There was a seminar on Christian and Jew for 2 days. So I went from Reading to Oxford, and I was late, you know, so the lecture was going on. So I collected my badge and everything and sat down. And when the lecture finished, a lady came, which was the priest over there, doctor or priest, a professor there. She called me, come. I went there. She said, you can't sit among the students with this hoodie on. What is written, they don't like it. And they say, what is underneath? Is it plain? I said, no, it's the same thing written there. It's a light on the living lampstand, which Jesus said people would not stumble into it. I don't throw pots before swine. Two men in Gennesaret was doing, and they ended up locked in the silence of the graveyard. But by the power of Holy Spirit, the chains were getting broken. And the people could not see it. and they still were locking them and putting chain, heavy chain around them. That means they were maltreating those two saints. And then Jesus came to redeem them and told them, don't throw pot before swine. Go somewhere else and preach gospel. And he drowned 2,000 swine to teach them a good lesson that if you maltreat a saint and that is your fate, as the swine has gone. And that is what happened in the temple. They died like swine. They are eating the shoes, belt, as the swine will chew the, anything that is leather. And that is how it happened. So go for gospel under the protection of our supernatural father. Satan cannot touch you. That's what Hazrat Muhammad Sahib said. Come to the fold of God, Allah. Allah and God is the same thing. Then the Satan can't touch you. So they are men of Egyptian because they were men of salt, faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. That is why they were eating meager. The elder son, you know, the prodigal son was the Isaac, the Jewish people who were unfaithful. The elder son, Ishmael, faithful. He remained with his father, Abraham, faithful to him. That's why young baby Jesus was sent to the care of Ishmael, because the people of Isaac, they wanted to kill him. That is the how much they love Christ Jesus, these Messianic Jews. They are hypocrites of the first degree. Matthew called him a heretic, and so am I a big heretic. When the old cloth, the written Torah, is full of holes, is patched with the brand new cloth, untouched by human hand, the gospel, they being not compatible, the tear becomes worse, and both, and spoils both cloths, because they can't understand old or the New Testament. Old is of the demiurge potter Yahweh, which apply to flesh, opposite apply to spirit, while the New Testament of Elohim, the gospel truth, that cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablets of heart, oral Torah, through logical reasoning called intuition, are taught by God himself, revelations. So that is how you get gospel, through revelations, intuition. So the Martian were telling them that they are not compatible. So that's why he took those, all those things which belong to the Old Testament away and created as much as possible pure New Testament, which the Messianic Jew hated. And as they had dwelt the all that system of Pope, everything like that, so they became the enemy of those who preach gospel. So try it. Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. Here I show you. If you want to try in a church and proclaim the simple gospel, that is the very simple thing. This is the below angel, John the Baptist. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. Luke 6, 16 verse 6. And so the sin finished here. After that, Jesus opened his narrow gate for the twice born people of Holy Spirit, common sense. And they have one father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And they are all sons of the Most High, no daughters, because your soul is concerned. So unless a female, a disciple like Saul, becomes a male, fall, he cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So here, you have all brethren, no sister here. Here you have brother and sister in flesh. Here in soul, we are all brethren, no sister here. So any in the church, if you call them, they call the woman a sister, that means they are spiritually blind. Woman has the same soul as a man. So she is our brother, that we are fishes of men, no woman. And you will be surprised in Athos, this Mount Athos in Greek. Over there they don't allow women on the mountain. Because this one is all male here. This is the royal kingdom of God. So they have no idea of this royal kingdom of God. But they know that there is no woman here. So they don't allow any woman on the mountain. Even not a female donkey is not allowed. You can see how stupid they are. They are buried in prayer and fasting, and they go by this monk says so, I have to do what he says. They are female disciples, like Saul was under Gamaliel. Saul was a female. When at Damascus gateway he became independent with the light of God, Christ. Then only he became a solitary and he became independent and entered the fold here, which is narrow gate, and here he became the son of the Most High, capable of preaching gospel very effectively because he had the knowledge of the oral written Torah, whereas the other apostles, they did not study the written Torah as Paul had done. So Paul has very clearly stated many things, where the other apostles, they just concentrated on spiritual side, not so much on moral side, rectifying another thing. Our Father God blessing you, and if anybody is interested in preaching gospel, he can talk to me on Skype, which is easy to use. And I would be glad to clarify anything, but he must open his mouth and preach gospel from the rooftop. Otherwise, what is given to him will be taken away from you, them, as it is true of these Messianic Jews. They had the knowledge as the temple priest over there when Jesus gave the last parable of the wine press, and the temple priest, the husbandmen, they knew he's pointing his finger at them. So they know, but they won't open their mouth for the gospel truth. So you must be able to open the mouth to preach gospel. And this is a t-shirt or hoodie, which you can, if you like, I can send you the design, and you can make one and put it on. To if somebody is interested, we will knock on your shoulder and tell him. But don't throw pearl before swine, otherwise you will be locked and you will be kicked out of the churches and all that. So just put this one on. If somebody is interested, well and good. If not, then don't throw pearls before swine. These are the pearls which you cannot throw before illiterate or once-born people. They will hate you, they will kick you, and they can kill you also. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love. So here is the question which you can love to ask these people in the churches. They will be very, I ask them, you know, and here it is. In Adam, we have races, under races, tribes, and the tribal people have the right to live on this planet Earth. That's why 144,000, they are all tribal people. In God, you have split yourself. And there's a Jew here. Okay.